It is just before sunrise on July the 2nd in the year 626 AD. Crown Prince Li Jianchang and the Prince of Qi Li Yuanji are riding horses toward the gigantic Xianwu Gate. The gate is still quiet and dark, and the deathly silence is a harbinger of what is about to happen. An unusual group of men suddenly emerges from the mist in this unusual location. Li Jianchang has no idea that a coup d'etat is afoot. The Crown Prince, like a lamb being led to the slaughter. He wonders what Li Shiming, a frequent planner of plots, is doing here at this moment. The sun is about to rise on June the 29th, 626 AD. It's an unusual day because Venus is appearing in the daytime southern sky. The ministers all notice this strange phenomenon as they exit the palace following the morning assembly. One by one, they stop to gaze at it. Crown Prince Li Jianchang has also noticed this unusual astronomical occurrence. The appearance of Venus in the sky is an omen warning of a change in ruler. The Tang Empire was growing stronger, but internal strife and foreign aggression were constant threats. The influence of the Prince of Qin Li Shiming was becoming a serious threat to the Crown Prince's political position at court. And meanwhile, a 100,000 strong army of Turks threatened the northern border. At this crucial juncture, an inauspicious omen appeared in the sky. All signs seemed to point to impending disaster.
Xing呢, 在古代的这个天人管营的观念中呢，也代表军事问题。如果它出现了异常，那就可能天下有兵乱。当时他的报告呢，太史局的报告也是这么说的，说这个太白金星。
For some reason, history hasn't recorded Li Jianchang's reaction to the omen. Since becoming the Crown Prince, Li Jianchang, eldest son of Li Yuan's first wife, had confined himself to administrative affairs in the palace. He was 10 years older than Li Shiming. But he seems not to have captured people's imagination as much as his illustrious younger brother had in his successful military campaigns.
建国之后呢，这个李渊做了皇帝，李建成就成为太子，而李世民是秦王嘛。那么太子做什么？太子在做日常工作呀，他在保护自己呀，也保护这个王朝的未来呀，所以他就不突出了。 那很多人讲这个问题，就是说李建成这时候黯然失色了。实际上，我说李世民当时是一个丢出去的人，他死了，马上李元吉去顶上，李元吉要再死了，还有其他将军顶上，但是李建成是绝对不能死，死了国本就没有，这国家的这个希望就没有了。所以现这个时候看起来，李建成做的事情就少了。It
is recorded in the New Book of Tang that Li Jianchang was a reckless spender and irresponsible alcoholic who spent most of his time hunting. This account asserts that the first Tang Crown Prince was a party animal and playboy. Other historical sources report much the same. His appointment as the Crown Prince seems to show that his father, Emperor Gaozu, was not very competent. The combination of a decadent Crown Prince and a blundering Emperor could spell disaster for the new Tang Dynasty. Yet somehow the Tang Dynasty did not die. Instead, it held on and continued to expand its territory during the 8 years that Li Jiancheng was the Crown Prince. In an historical record written in the early 13th century, Li Jiancheng is described as generous and open-minded. This happens to be in line with the description of Li Yuan in other sources. In terms of governance, Li Jiancheng resembled his father more than his record. In 626 AD, Li Jiancheng was 37 years of age. Emperor Gaozu was growing old. Because of this, many state affairs were delegated to the Crown Prince in his eastern palace, and this left him little leisure time. At that time, people around the country were pleading for relief from the serious drought affecting the country. This created a huge administrative burden for Li Jiancheng to handle. However, there was also another matter that occupied his attention. Two years earlier, Li Jiancheng presented General Yang Wengan with a gift of armor without the emperor's authorization. This seemingly ordinary gift led to an armed rebellion that shook the empire. Li Jiancheng had become involved in this affair, and it nearly cost him the title of Crown Prince. In the end, there was no definite resolution, but there were many suspicions. Although there was no conclusive evidence that Li Shimin was behind the incident, it marked the beginning of open political conflict between the Crown Prince and Li Shimin. A clash seemed unavoidable.
这个事儿呢，斗争现在已经到了这个程度，到了有你没我的程度了。这个其中呢，里面有一个很重要的环节，就是皇帝有一个理念头，就是李渊认为隋朝之所以那么快的灭亡，原因就是怀太子。如果是杨勇继续当太子，而不是隋炀帝代替他哥哥，隋朝不至于这么快灭亡。所以太子不可以轻易的换，这是国本不可轻易动摇。
Emperor Gaozu was now 60 years old, and at the time, this was considered an advanced age. Feeling his mortality, he began making preparations for the time after he was gone. He was, after all, well aware of the way the Sui Dynasty had fallen after the change of Crown Prince, so he refused to remove Li Jiancheng after naming him as his heir. Li Jiancheng was now the powerful Crown Prince, backed by his imperial father. He could easily attack Li Shimin via his father's imperial edicts, starting by getting rid of some of Li Shimin's advisors.
Because 后来有那么大的势力，是因为他有一个庞大的秦王府。这秦王府里有文臣，有武将，这些人当时都被人挖了墙角。还有一个战场就是宫廷的世界。当时，这个李建成和李元吉他们拼命的讨好后宫，让后宫形成了针对李世民的又一个战线。 这个也是一个很有力的战线，吹枕头风嘛。所以这些呢，都使得李世民觉得深受打击，后宫没有人替他说话。
The dismissal of Li Shimin's advisors and his loss of support among the harem were heavy blows against which he was powerless to defend himself. The next step for the Crown Prince was to remove Li Shimin's most crucial political asset, the army generals who were loyal to him. After serving in so many battles at Li Shimin's side, simply transferring them or buying their loyalty would obviously not be enough.Li Jianchang needed to permanently get rid of all these military officers at one time. Eastern Palace, it was dinner time and the lights were burning bright. Li Jianchang planned to host a banquet for his brothers Li Shimin, the Prince of Qin, and Li Yuanji, the Prince of Qi. But this would be no ordinary banquet.
还能坐在一起喝酒，这说明至少表面关系还行。因为杨慕干事件以后，皇帝也很伤心，希望兄弟们能够像真的像兄弟一样，啊，不要像敌人一样，所以这个彼此这个请酒呢，大概也算正常，至少他们表面还能过得去。
First to arrive was Li Yuanji, the Prince of Qi, who lived just next door. Unlike Li Shimin, the younger son of Li Yuan's first wife, Li Yuanji always got along with his eldest brother and was his most reliable ally in the political struggle.Li Yuanji, always quick-tempered, seemed particularly on edge today, however. According to a palace rumor, the emperor was about to announce the appointment of Li Yuanji as Grand Marshal of the Army to lead the fight against the Turks.
When was the most powerful person in the time of the Emperor? It was Li Shimin. If the Emperor Li Yuan still trusted Li Shimin, he should have sent Li Shimin to.打这个突厥，可事实上李渊派的不是李世民，而是李元吉。李元吉去打仗了，那李元吉就跟这个皇帝讲啊，我手下兵马不够，咱们多派点精兵强将来跟随我。派到的是谁呢？他跟父亲要求的就是秦府的这些核心人物。
Li Jianchang actually gave his father the idea for this order. He was very happy with the outcome. It would put Li Shimin in a perilous position. Not only did Li Shimin lose his military power, but also the generals who he had nurtured through years of military campaigns. More importantly, the order had come directly from the emperor.So he was powerless to counteract it. Li Jianchang now believed that his capable younger brother was powerless. Perhaps because victory had come so easily, or maybe because of the wine, Li Yuanji suggested a bold plan to his oldest brother.
如今秦王府诸将已归我管辖，秦王府已是空中楼阁，要不然借此机会咱们把李世民
不可了。
大哥，我是为了大哥着想啊，不是为了我。
Li Shiming arrived, and the three brothers sat down to drink, but each with his own thoughts. There were probably very few gatherings like this after the Yang Wengan incident. But by now, the lure of power and political struggles had sowed irreversible discord among the brothers, and the joy of drinking barely concealed the resentment and friction. Perhaps even they themselves would have found it difficult to explain how they went from brothers who were very close to constantly warring political opponents. This was truly no ordinary gathering.
房位继承这个问题上，最关键的不是继承人的资格，继承人的能力，继承人的这个才智，不是这样的问题，而是继承的稳定性。所以呢，从西周开始确立了这种嫡长子继承制，其实就是要强调一个稳定性。但是当然，它也有它的不合理的地方，它的不合理的地方就是，它不利于把一些有特殊才能的人。 和这个有功劳的人提拔到这个最适合他的位置上来，但是话又说回来了，这个有功什么叫有功？这功的大小由谁来定？那么比如说这几个儿子都认为自己有功，他还是要争。Personal
problems and political struggle had turned the three close brothers into arch enemies. But now they were sitting together and pretended to be cheerful in what was an awkward situation. They were well aware that all their conversation would seem superfluous and insincere. And perhaps this is why there's no detailed record concerning this banquet. Li Shiming soon passed out drunk, and he had to be carried back to his residence by an attendant. Li Yuanji took the opportunity to leave as well, still feeling very pleased with himself because of his new position. When his residence was finally quiet, the Crown Prince began mulling over some crucial matters. Since the Yang Wengan incident, tensions between Li Jiancheng and Li Shiming were no longer a secret. Conflict over the right of succession has never been resolved over a few drinks. Killing Li Shiming was certainly the most direct and absolute means of resolving the matter, but it seemed unlikely that the even-tempered Li Jiancheng would consider this course of action. The following version of events is from the New Book of Tang. It tells us that the night before Li Yuanji was to receive the order to go to battle, Li Shiming's informant in Li Yuanji's residence, Wang Zhi, brought alarming news. Li Jiancheng planned to secretly have Li Shiming assassinated during the kickoff ceremony for Li Yuanji's campaign. Li Yuanji, in his authority as Grand Marshal, would then later find an excuse to bury alive all the military officers belonging to Li Shiming. Li Jiancheng not only wanted to kill Li Shiming, he also wanted to get rid of all the officers attached to his residence.
就比方说尉迟敬德，比方说程世杰等等这些人，他都要求随从他上前线。 那当然，将在外，军命有所不受。如果是主帅想要干掉哪一个将领的话，这是易如反掌的事情。如果他们在战场不再决定追随他的话，很可能就要被他屠杀掉了。
Li Jiancheng has perhaps not surprisingly been widely condemned for this vicious plot. Many believe that it was this assassination plot that led to the Xuanwu Gate incident. But Sima Guang's unique version of this event, as recorded in Comprehensive Mirror to Aid in Government from the same period as the New Book of Tang, raises some questions.
Sima Guang 专门写了一段考译在这个地方，他 他就最后他的处理就是不把它作为一个事实来描写，只是传言，只是听说有人说这样有这么一个计划，但是司马光也没有把它作为事实，因为司马光他有一个最基本的判断，就是认为李渊的当时并没有下决心要消灭谁或者杀死谁，所以两方面要废掉建成他也不同意，你要杀死李世民他也不同意，他是不会同意这件事情的。
During the Tang Dynasty, this ceremony for a campaign led by a prince was second only in importance to that for a campaign led by the emperor himself. Assassinating Li Shiming during such a ceremony in front of so many people would not have been easy. In fact, it would have been very difficult to plan to successfully execute him. Furthermore, even if the plot was successful, they would have had to deal with one important person who would have been upset by the killing, the emperor himself. The Yang Wengan incident had opened Li Yuan's eyes to the political struggle between his two sons. If Li Shimin were to suddenly die in front of the court officials, Li Yuan would certainly be able to guess who the perpetrator was. Furthermore, the plan would be extremely difficult to execute successfully, and it was likely someone would discover the plot. It didn't really seem necessary for Li Jiancheng as the crown prince to take such a risk. The elements of the plot also merit review. According to the New Book of Tang, Li Jiancheng planned to take out Li Shimin at the campaign kickoff ceremony, then later bury alive his military officers. But if Li Shimin were assassinated during the ceremony, it shouldn't have been necessary to deal with his military officers. The generals now under Li Yuanji would have to be present and fully armed at the ceremony. An attempt to kill Li Shimin in full view of the generals loyal to him would be very risky, successful or not. Moreover, there's another suspicious detail that can't be overlooked. Li Yuanji's suggestion is recorded in the Old Book of Tang. He is recorded as plotting multiple previous attacks on Li Shimin in many historical records. All of these plots seemed very plausible, but none were actually carried out. Sima Guang's explanation.
那他们是想来着还是没想？这是永远弄不清楚的事情。
Late at night, Crown Prince Li Jianchang was preparing for bed when alarming news arrived. After an evening of drinking, Li Shimin had returned home and suddenly started vomiting blood. It had certainly not been an ordinary banquet.
当场并没有发作，当场只不过是说有点喝酒喝多了的样子，喝醉了什么的，然后被李道宗给背回去了。他的吐血多少升什么的，都是他自己报告的，都是秦王府报告的，说在家里面吐了很多很多。
李世民 suddenly began vomiting blood after returning from an evening of eating and drinking at the Eastern Palace. If this was indeed a case of poisoning, it would be logical to assume that Li Jianchang was behind it. But this seems too obvious. The previous assassination plot had only the slightest chance of being carried out in secrecy. A poisoning like this would have been even harder to hide, besides which, the target didn't even die.
东宫是否投毒，这个事情其实还仍然是一个谜。比如说，你要想杀他，有很多办法，包括投毒，那就是剂量大点不就完了，是吧？想要死他还做不到吗？结果呢，当场并没有发作。
If Li Jianchang had really attempted to poison his brother at his own residence but failed, his plan must have been very poorly thought out, and it certainly would have angered the emperor. It's difficult to see what the crown prince would have expected to gain from such a plot, but it is possible that somebody else was behind the poisoning. Li Wanji, the Prince of Qi, was quicker to anger than the Crown Prince.
相争啊，关键别人都不重要，就是关键就是你们俩人。如果把秦王拿下，那个秦王府就没有了，就不存在了，所以就很简单。
Wei Zheng is a familiar figure in Tang history. After Li Shimin became Emperor Taizong, Wei Zheng became the most renowned minister in Chinese history. His relationship with Li Shimin was held up by later generations as a model for relations between ruler and minister. Yet few remember that while Li Shimin was still Prince of Qin, Wei Zheng was an advisor to Li Jianchang. During his period as advisor to Li Jianchang, Wei Zheng had proposed many times that Li Jianchang should get rid of Li Shimin and end the political struggle once and for all. Despite holding Wei Zheng in high regard, Li Jianchang never consented to his proposals.
Dianxia, Wei Zheng 绝不会在没有殿下指示的情况下对秦王下毒。秦王中毒，一定另有他由。
Wei Zheng agreed with Li Yuanji that Li Shimin needed to be eliminated. But Wei Zheng was just an advisor to the Crown Prince, so he dared not act without the consent of the Crown Prince. Emperor Gaozu issued a royal decree. He ordered that because the Prince of Qin couldn't handle his liquor, he was henceforth forbidden to go out drinking at night. Notice that Li Yuan's decree said nothing about Li Shimin's poisoning. It simply forbade the Crown Prince from drinking with Li Shimin because the latter couldn't handle his liquor.
Li Shimin 不善饮酒，这皇帝话就是证明了这一点。所以喝点酒有可能醉，这是一点。喝多了。这个胃出血也不是不可能，喝多了有可能引起胃出血，吐点血也正常，但是就说一定是投毒，这有可能是个苦肉计的表达。究竟是 被投毒了，还是李世民用了苦肉计，这个事儿说不清。
After issuing his edict to the crown prince, Emperor Gao Zu personally went to visit Li Shimin. As the emperor sat next to his bed, the father and son had a heart-to-heart talk.
所以秦王府很高兴。
父皇，儿臣。儿臣不愿离开父皇，父皇。
天下都是一家，东都和西都两地路程很近，只要朕想念你，便可动身前往。
后来这个事情被拦住了，那就是被太子和齐王拦住了。他们计算了一下，如果李世民真的去了洛阳，问题严重。那就是洛阳这边的条件更好，资源更丰富。如果以后皇帝不在了，兄弟之间敌国相争的话，可能打不过李世民，所以一定要把他办在这个长安。于是就找大臣、找皇帝去说，最后其实皇帝这个命令没有执行，就没有让李世民去洛阳。
The emperor's proposal would divide the land he had worked so hard to conquer between two of his sons. It must have been an agonizing decision for Tang Dynasty founder Li Yuan. No one knows how much the emperor had to silently endure because of the wild nature of his sons.
所以李渊是一个很挣扎的状态，就是他一方面是个父亲，不希望看。
Both the poisoning in the Eastern Palace and the Yang Wengan incident preceding it revolved around the position of Crown Prince. The direct goal of these incidents was to tarnish the image of Li Jianchang in the eyes of the Emperor.But in the wake of these incidents, Li Jianchang did nothing. And the only reason there were no consequences afterwards was his father's hesitancy. Suppose, however, that Li Jianchang had been removed from his position as Crown Prince. Most likely to take his place would undoubtedly have been Li Shimin, a general with an excellent military record.And victim of the poisoning attack. Li Jianchang and his advisors must have realized this. Because there were no consequences for anyone after these two incidents, the conflict between Li Jianchang and Li Shimin continued to escalate. Everyone could see that a final showdown was inevitable.Late at night on June the 30th, 626 AD, news came from the palace that in the morning, Emperor Gao Zu would formally announce the appointment of Li Yuanji as Grand Marshal. Nobody knew how Li Shimin would react. At this crucial moment, Wei Zheng was ill. Li Jianchang came to Wei Zheng's residence to get advice from his trusted advisor.
殿下，眼下之事虽有利于东宫，然秦王绝非束手就擒之辈。所谓穷寇莫追啊！
魏征跟这个太子关系还是不错，太子在很多方面也是听从魏征的主张的。但是只有这个事儿，太子没有听，那就是魏征建议杀掉秦王李世民，太子没有听。 越是大言之节，越要小心行事啊！你还是先保重自己的身体。臣无恙，请太子三思啊！那太子为什么没有听这个建议？那想来呢，大概最多是两个原因：一个是他觉得自己稳扎胜券，不必采取这种极端的手段。
Judging from the way the Xuanwu Gate incident unfolded, it seems that Li Jiancheng didn't take Wei Zheng's warning seriously. Perhaps he reasoned that with Li Yuanji in control of the military, Li Shumin's greatest political asset would be gone. He believed that with his father's support, he could easily overcome Li Shumin's resistance and become emperor. Since he could defeat Li Shumin without bloodshed, there was no real reason to kill his own brother. The soft-hearted Li Jiancheng, described by Sima Guang, was obviously unaware of the stealthily approaching danger. In this respect, Li Jiancheng had too much in common with his father Li Yuan.
仁厚，这是大家对他的公认的评价。仁厚既是优点，也是缺点。仁厚在什么时候是优点？如果真的是治理国家、跟百姓打交道的时候，绝对可以作为优点存在。他永远不把别人往最坏的那个方向想。 但是不把政敌往最坏的方向想，最后就可能把自己逼到这个道上。所以我想呢，李建成是一个很倒霉的人，他倒霉的就是他生在这样的一个比较动荡的这个年代，就是需要争皇位的这样的一个年代。如果他没有这样的一个大前提，没有天下大乱，他弟弟建功立业这样一个大前提，让他成为一个稳定时代的君主的话，他可能成为一个好君主。
Li Jiancheng left Wei Zheng to go to bed in his residence. He wondered what would happen at court in the morning. He wondered if the devious Li Shumin would willingly give up his military power. But whatever happened, Li Jiancheng was sure that Li Shumin would comply with an imperial edict. Thus, everything seemed to be going well. But in reality, Li Jiancheng's time was rapidly running out. He had no idea that he would soon commit his final act. What chance turn of events prompted Li Shumin to carry out the Xuanwu Gate incident?
太白入侵分这个天象，就是发动军人政变。我等不是任人宰割，反抗之祸。身边都没有人。Faced
with these circumstances, what would Li Shumin do?
我来说话，公平不淫乱。老皇帝现在急了。
Please join us for the next part of the Xuanwu Gate incident.